Hello, welcome to Tabor Talk. Hello, people. Another edition here to Tabor Talk. So my last video recording was on racism in America, and I had showed a clip of Morgan Freeman, who stated, he was on Don Lemon, and he stated that, you know, race has no, it's not even a factor or variable when it comes to success. And he had a good point. I played it, it was awesome, and I talked about it a little bit. So let me just be clear here, because some people on the right, I've received some text messages, and it's like, oh, Mike, you think we ought to have, you know, laws stating that blacks and minorities and women should have special treatment, preferential treatment, like, you know, affirmative action programs and quota systems and all that. No, absolutely not. I'm not really, definitely not quota systems. I am totally opposed to that. You would think that I would be for it because I'm a progressive liberal. I am not. I think it's bullshit. Any sort of quota system and even in affirmative action as well. Right, in theory, affirmative action is all things being equal. If they're totally equal, and that's almost impossible. Like, we're all different. And if you think that everyone's exactly the same, you're not. You should probe further, and whatever. So I used to be a recruiter, so I know all about interviewing and, you know, gauging skill sets and talents and all that. But anyway, the theory of affirmative action is that if all things given even, you should give it to the black person or woman. And fuck that, it's bullshit. No. That's not what I'm saying at all. All I'm saying is that Morgan Freeman and Don Lemon are very successful African-American men. It doesn't matter. This racism is not going to affect them. They're super famous and successful. I'm talking about the people who don't have the skill sets and talents of a Morgan Freeman or the intelligence or the looks of a Don Lemon or whatever. I'm talking about the people who fall through the cracks. Let me say that again. Fall through the cracks. There are tens of millions of people who are not smart, who are poor, and have shitty education, and they just don't make it, you know? You know, not everyone's fucking smart like Don Lemon, all right? So those are the people I'm talking about. What do you want to do with these people? Just shit on them? Put them in, I don't know, maybe Trump says put them in a cage or something, you know, right? You're a loser. That's Trump says, you're a loser, you know? So, listen, I subscribe to, yes, hard work and discipline. That's your best shot. Life is not fair. Life is absolutely not fair. And we try to make things as level as possible. I mean, that, right? Isn't that what we want? Right? In the greatest country in the world, in America, try to make it as level as possible. But the thing is, there's some people who are just not going to make it. There are losers. Right? There are losers in this life. So my question is, you want to be a right-wing asshole and just say, fuck them, let them die, homeless, sleep on the street, and your feces and all that crap? All right? So all I'm saying is a little compassion. I mean, obviously, I'm stating the obvious, that we have an obligation to take care of the infirmed, the poor and the elderly, the infirm, the poor and the elderly, you know, right? And just recognize that some people who are just fucked in life, you know, and regardless of how hard they work, yes, you should work hard. Everyone should work as hard as they can. There are people who work so hard and just don't have it. They just don't have it. It's just the way it is. Maybe they're not born. They're not very smart, very low IQ, they're ugly physically maybe, who the hell knows? There are a myriad of reasons. So there's that, just, you know, I believe taking care of people who are downing out. And then also the second part before I end this is just to recognize that institutional racism has existed for decades and hundreds of years, and you just can't overturn it. I talked about the magic pill on my last video. If we had a pill, if you ingested it, and then racism would be gone tomorrow, we obviously would still have huge problems because of these decades and hundreds of years of these institutions that have been keeping black people and women down for years. It's like a gigantic battleship, right? Like, turn it around, turning around racism and sexism, turning around the battleship. That takes a long, long time. And we don't need a racist Trump to stop the turn. He wants to bring us back to the 50s. As he would say, the good old days, the 50s and 60s, where women are in their place, or minorities. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. That's what Trump wants. All right. Okay. I think that's enough for this video recording. It's a wonderful day. It's actually very warm now. And this is Taper Talk, and let me fade out with some Rush and Limelight. Everyone have an awesome day. Here's the circle. I'm going to be more professional. I keep saying it. Have an awesome day, everyone. Peace, love, and understanding. Message from Taper Talk. Peace, love, and understanding.